Hello, everyone. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome. Time for us to get this event started. If you guys are ready, why don't we go ahead and get our groove on? Let's go. Wherever you are, I want to see you dancing in your seats, moving your feet. Let's go ahead and have a good time, everybody. Hey, 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 hey. Let's groove tonight. Share the spice and light. And baby, slice it right. We're gonna groove tonight. Hey, let this groove get you to move. It's all right, all right, all right. Let this groove set in your shoes and stand up. All right, all right. Gonna tell you what you can do with my love. Looking good, you're out of sight. All right, just groove yourself and glide like a 747 and lose yourself in the sky among the clouds and the heavens, y'all. Let this groove get you to move. It's all right, all right.
All right. Ooh, I'm still dancing. Woo. Great job, Lindsay. How's everybody feeling tonight? Let's get this party started. Well, welcome to the 22nd annual Champions for Children Gala Benefit. I'm Carlos Carter, the Executive Director of Homeless Children's Education Fund. As you can see, I am so excited to be here and excited that you are here. You are tuning in and staying connected to our cause because it means so much to me and us. You know, my vision for HCEF is that every kid will be able to achieve success despite their housing status. The kids experiencing homelessness will be able to create a broader vision for themselves that transcends stereotypes in their current living situations. And that's important because our kids face so many challenges, even though they have so many strengths, and it's our job to help them to prepare for the future, leveraging education. You know, I am so blessed and privileged to lead this great organization that does amazing work. Not only does my board and team serve the community, but guess what? They do it with love and compassion. I guarantee you, you will be inspired by tonight's program while experiencing some great entertainment from the lovely Lindsay Smith. You heard a little bit of her now, but there's more coming. And also, I heard a rumor that the Black Frank Sinatra will be in the house tonight. Let's see if he shows up, so stay tuned. What a year we've all had. Most of you know our tagline is creating hope through learning. So tonight, we are staying true to the theme of hope. Our youth and families give us hope. Our donors give us hope. And events like this give us hope. Heck, you give us hope. You can live about 40 days without food, 3 days without water, 8 minutes without air, but not 1 second without hope. First things first, I'd like to recognize our sponsors who are making this evening a great success. Our three platinum sponsors are Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield and Gateway Health and UPMC Health Plan. They each would like the opportunity to greet you and thank you for coming. Highmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield has been a great partner for many years, and we're just so thankful for your support of our mission. And so now we're gonna hear from Neil, who's gonna share a few words with us.
Hello, I'm Neil Parham, Corporate Giving Director with Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, and I would like to welcome you to the 2021 Champions for Children benefit. Highmark is pleased to continue supporting the great work of the Homeless Children's Education Fund. We have a shared commitment to helping our youth become productive and empowered citizens and are proud to be a sponsor of this year's Champions for Children benefit.
Thank you, Neil. Our next platinum sponsor is Gateway. And I also want to give a special shout out to my friend, Marcia Martin. She's just amazing. Gateway has been a great partner as well. And so we're going to hear from Rodney Robbins. So Rodney, let's hear from you.
Good evening. My name is Rodney Robbins, and I'm the Director of Corporate Social Responsibility for Gateway Health. Gateway is extremely proud to support the Homeless Children's Education Fund and their mission to support youth experiencing homelessness and also to provide them with the resources and tools that they need to be productive citizens. By supporting organizations such as HCEF, we are able to address social determinants of health and also to provide care for the whole person in our communities that need the most support. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rodney, for your remarks, and definitely appreciate your partnership. Our third platinum sponsor is UPMC Health Plan. They provided some remarks for me to share. Before I do that, I want to get a shout out to Kimberly Orth, a great supporter, former board member, and John Lovelace, a former board member, a great supporter as well, and Maris Bondi. So we appreciate all of you guys. So their statement is, as a regional health insurance plan committed to being a part of all the communities where our members live, we recognize that health depends upon more than just access to healthcare. Health inequities and other socioeconomic realities can also impact individual and community health. Without access to fresh food, stable housing, or strong educational and job training resources, public health can suffer. That's why we consider it part of our mission to help bridge these gaps in access and work with community-oriented, mission-driven partners like HCEF. By providing strong resources to help address health disparities, HCEF is improving opportunities and healthcare outcomes for children they serve, and we are honored to sponsor and support the great work. Thank you so much, UPMC Health Plan, for your sponsorship and support, and for those great, great remarks. We also have three wonderful loyal gold sponsors, Pitt, Ohio, 100 Acres Manor, and civil and environmental consultants all have supported us for many years. We thank you so much. And we also have 13. Yes, 13 silver sponsors. We appreciate all of you guys a lot as well. All of you have been great partners, and we're just so grateful for you all. And last but not least, we have our dedicated host, what a wonderful host. Thank you guys so much. And also our creative basket donors. The baskets are amazing. You haven't seen them. You have to bid on them. They're awesome. But you can see it takes a team effort to bring hope to you. And now, it is my pleasure to introduce our charming MC for the evening, the lovely Miss Wadria Taylor of Style and Steel. You know, Wadria is the founder of Style and Steel Event Planning. She actually did our CHAMPS event some years back in Style Week, Pittsburgh. She is also a serial entrepreneur and speaker straight out of Brooklyn by way of Jamaica. Speaking of Jamaica, that's where my lovely bow tie came from. I had to take a while for it to get here, but lovely things come from Jamaica, and I think Wadria is definitely testament to that. She also has a big heart and is a light that illuminates and inspires everyone who has a pleasure to experience her. She also is very stylish, but we wouldn't expect any less considering she is the founder of Style Week Pittsburgh and Style and Steel. So without any further ado, Ms. Wadria Taylor.
Thank you so much for those kind words, Carlos. You know, great things take time. You are looking dapper.
Thank you so much.
I'm loving your bow tie. You know, I always like to say there is something extra special about Jamaicans. So I am not surprised that it was a Jamaican designer that designed your beautiful bow tie. Well, great evening, everyone. Are you guys excited? Wasn't Lindsay great? I'm already feeling your energy through the chat section. Thank you, Carlos, right? Thank you, Carlos, again for asking me to be a part of this special night. This is a wonderful occasion to be here. And as Carlos said, I mean, what a year it has been, everyone. It's been an incredible year as well as an unprecedented one, you know, one that we've experienced in our own way. But hopefully we've all learned a lot. I know I have. We've learned about how much we need one another, and more importantly, how much organizations like HCEF mean to help our communities during these unprecedented times. So listen, we're going to have a great time. I know that you are here because you care, and you've already gotten a little taste of what we have in store for you. Was it, again, Lindsay, awesome? I was over here jamming. And we have a lot more of that in store for you. And, you know, we're definitely going to have fun. You're going to be inspired. You're certainly going to be moved. And you've already gotten the clue. I didn't think I would have to say. You guys are so sharp. You're already using the chat box. So I want you to continue using it, all right? Let's start it up again right now, because I think it would be great to know where you are all zooming in from. So right now, take a little second, drop a message in the chat section, tell us where you are zooming in from, where you are joining us from. And you already know that we have an awesome silent auction going on. Listen, I got a sneak peek of the items before they went live. So I'm already eyeing a couple of things. So if you have not already, you know, the link will be in the chat. And if you need any assistance throughout the course of the night navigating, we'll do the best that we can to assist you. But listen, we got some good stuff. There's a week-long stay to St. Martin. That's the one I'm eyeing. We have some fabulous wine baskets, just a lot of great items. So it will end at 8:30 sharp, all right? Not 8:29, not 8:31. Not 8:35, all right, 8:30 sharp. And if you happen to win, you will get a detailed email of how and when to claim your item. So Carlos, let's just talk for a bit. Tell me, what has this year been like specifically for your students and young people that you're serving? I mean, so many of them, all of them, right, had to be going to school remotely, virtually. I can't even imagine that. So how has this been for them?
First of all, I say our students are smart, they're brilliant, they're hardworking, but it's so hard to be awesome when you're hungry. It's hard to be to really excel at your schoolwork, you know, have access to computers and internet and things like that. And so we really had to pivot. You know, when a crisis or a challenge has happened, you have a choice of either to fight, flight, freeze, or appease. And we had to fight, right? To fight for our students. We had to be creative and figure out, you know, we have to still make their support, make sure they're supported, but we had to be creative in how we did that. And so we provided food, we provided computers, internet, we provided a shoulder to cry on, anything it takes to support our families to get them connected with school. But more importantly, it's important to us that our students feel loved, valued, and supported first, and we support their education. So we had to do, you know, with great board support and donor support to really step up and help our families.
Wow. Well, you and your staff are incredible. I like to say that teamwork is dream work. And certainly most of us never had to navigate the way that our young people, and even as a staff that you all have, and you've been so resilient and remarkable. And with that, you know, I'd like to introduce you all now to some of the fabulous staff at HCEF. We've got Chris, Alizé, Caitlin, and Brian, and they're going to share with you, you know, what's happened since last March when everything completely changed for all of us. So take a look.
Our work expanded beyond educational support to housing support, and then ultimately mental health supports. A lot of our families, you know, they get two hot meals at school every day. And what was that going to look like without that option for mom and her kids?
I was really stuck thinking, how are we going to be able to make things a little bit easier for the families that we're working with, since we couldn't be in the spaces that we usually were in to do that kind of thing?
A lot of our students had not yet received the technology they needed for virtual online learning. Internet connectivity was a huge challenge.
We worked on adapting a model where we could interact with students virtually.
And there was, like I said, a student who was in just a great need of just needing that in-person support, needing those social interactions that they weren't getting through virtual learning. So we had somebody go out to that child's home, and then we followed all, you know, COVID guidelines of making sure that you're 6 feet apart, wearing masks. And we basically set up a table outside of their house. And we did tutoring outside on their porch.
In a normal year, our school districts did a really great job in identifying families facing housing instability. At the beginning of the year, requests for transportation are sent out. And if an address has changed, you know, it's a very specific form that's sent to families to gauge whether they are facing housing instability or homelessness. We're all at home though now, and there is no need for busing and transportation to school. So the school's main source of identifying families is no longer in place. For many of our students, this has been a lost year. They have not done well. They have not completed the work and the credits that they need to move forward. And that is also giving them, is also increasing their levels of desperation, of hopelessness, of uncertainty about what their life is going to look like moving forward.
Students who already struggled with their social skills, that wasn't being built upon because they weren't placed in an environment where they could grow those skills. So I think that was very hard for them within their virtual learning. I think a lot of students then felt a lot of anxiety when it came to doing their virtual learning through school by using their camera as their main source of interaction. You know, it was just ended up being another factor that played into the life that made things a lot difficult.
all of our students signed up to college in the training programs that they're at for in-person learning. And they didn't have a choice when it moved online. And for some of our students, when the dorms closed, they found themselves homeless again. I'm no longer homeless. I'm moving into the dorm. And I have an address. I have a stable place where I'm going to be. And now the dorms are closed and I can't, where am I going to go? That was a great challenge for many of our students. And while many have adjusted, some have not. At the onset of the pandemic, this young woman and her mother were not getting along well at all. And mom kicked her daughter out, and she was bouncing around for a while and wasn't sure what her future looked like at all. And the fact that we were able to connect with her and regularly meet with her and provide her with the support that we adjusted. You know, a lot of the support that we offered to her, we typically wouldn't be offering in years past. She's been accepted to college. She has her financial aid package. She is in the midst of completing her Hope Through Learning Award application now. And she's hopeful for her future.
I am so energized by the collaborations that we have made during this time. The other organizations that we've worked with, the other community partners, the new families, the students, and even this new way of providing programming to the mix of what we hope to continue to do now going forward and into the summer. All of this has really energized me in a way to think more creatively about the work that we do. And it's also reminded me of how critical and important it is to be able to do the things that we do, and how honored I am to be able to work with the families that we work with every day and the students that we get to work with.
Zoom is going to be a part of our work. Virtual meetings are going to be a part of our work, even in a post-pandemic world. We can do a whole lot here.
Through virtual learning, we were able to help a family build a better relationship with the school that their child was going to. So we were able to have that parent build a better connection and interaction with the teacher by creating like a Zoom meeting, and then they can meet in person over Zoom and have a conversation with one another and how we can help support that student. And now that parent is talking, you know, to the teachers almost on a regular basis to make sure that they're being a better support system.
We built a lot of great relationships over the course of the pandemic in response to crisis that we're gonna maintain moving forward.
I made a lot of friends with a lot of great organizations and a lot of great people, and I'm very hopeful that those relationships will continue in the years ahead. What the pandemic has, I believe, brought is an awareness that all of our mental health needs to be a priority, and self-care, and that it's not a sign of weakness or shame to ask for help around these matters. So I'm encouraged by our students and our families going to be able to access more supports for their mental health than they had prior.
At HCEF, we're all about creating hope through learning, and we've really done a lot in this time where everyone was feeling disconnected to help build new bridges and to build new connections throughout the community during this difficult time. We've really come together in a lot of wonderful ways, both with community partners, with schools, with other family members and students in ways that we hadn't before. And I'm hopeful for those relationships and how they can help drive our work going forward to make it more impactful and make it more meaningful.
Wow, thank you to all of the staff members at HCEF. None of this work would be possible without all of you. So as I mentioned at the beginning, I told you guys that you're in for a fun night and we're about to elevate things and take things to another level. I would like to welcome back my fabulous co-host, who, as you know, is also the executive director at HCEF, but a lot of you don't know that Carlos, not only is he's fighting homelessness during the day, and at night he is moonlighting as a singer. Well, not quite, but he has a fabulous voice, and you're getting ready to, you're going to hear from him right now. He is singing a Frank Sinatra song, The Way You Look Tonight, and a little special story. He is singing from the Manchester Craftsman's Guild recording studio, which is also the same studio that Nancy Wilson and Grammy Award winning Nancy Wilson recorded some of her music as well. So I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Carlos Carter.
Hey, how's everyone tonight? I'm having a great time. I hope you are too.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I can feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight.
Yeah.
Yes, your love. Your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft, there is nothing for me but to love you and the way you look tonight.
Listen,
with these words your tenderness grows, tearing my fears apart. And that laugh wrinkles your nose, it touches my foolish heart. Lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm, won't you please arrange it, 'cause I love you and the way you look tonight.
Hey, come on y'all, come on, move a little. Fun. Can't you tell?
And that laugh that wrinkles your nose, it touches my foolish heart. Lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm, won't you please arrange it, 'cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way you look tonight.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wow. Wasn't that amazing, guys? Show Carlos some love. I already see some of the love in the chat section. Carlos, I'm speechless. That was amazing. I'm over here bopping. I'm like, oh, wait, we're back. that got us moving. You know, if your spirits weren't high or they were already high, they just got higher. That was awesome. And what a great transition into our award segment. We have recognition that is happening right now. And listen, this year we have two champions and also the Linda Dickerson Award. And Carlos and Board Chair Joe Clark will do these presentations to our awardees. So back to you. And by the way, guys, you know, I'm Carlos's manager. So he's available for bookings, bar mitzvahs, all of it. Reach out to me personally. But back to you, Carlos. You're amazing.
Thank you so much, Wadrian. And thank you guys for all the nice comments in the chat. You're so good for my self-esteem. I really had a great time doing that. So thank you for your support. I appreciate it. So now to start this awards segment, we have some great awardees. The first champion I'd like to announce is Child Guidance Foundation and executive director Pam Golden. I call her big sister Pam. And so, you know, no great organization is great without a great leader. And she's been a great mentor for me and just helped me navigate my role here and just so many things they've done and, you know, provided probably over 100,000 in funding to support our work. So we really appreciate Child Guidance and Pam and her partnership. And we can't do what we do without people like you. And so this award is very deserved. And so now we'll hear from Pam.
On behalf of the Pittsburgh Child Guidance Foundation Board, thank you so much for this honor. The foundation was established almost 40 years ago for the purpose of improving the emotional health and well-being of children and youth in Allegheny County. Over the decades, our area of emphasis has shifted a little, but it's allowed us to stay true to our original mission by providing grants and collaborating with public and private organizations to implement innovative policies and practices and programs to help children of Allegheny County. In 2014, we conducted extensive research to understand the pressing issues that were facing children and youth that inhibited their ability to thrive and lead productive, fulfilling lives. The issue that arose time and again was the increasing number of children and youth experiencing homelessness. In so many cases, the children are victimized by decisions and actions of adults in their lives. Far too often, the children are invisible. They're not counted, or their needs are not taken into consideration when decisions are being made about what services the family will receive. Being homeless or being in an untenable situation such as domestic violence or in a home where there's substance or sexual abuse can lead to homelessness. These adverse childhood experiences are directly linked to emotional, physical, and mental health problems later in life. There are steep costs to neglecting the emotional health of the children. These costs come not only to the children, but to the family and to society as well. We know that having caring, concerned adults in their lives can make a difference. The Pittsburgh Child Guidance Foundation wants to be counted among those adults who are making a difference. In 2014, the board agreed unanimously that our area of emphasis would be to address the needs of the children experiencing homelessness. We would commit our resources to mitigating the circumstances of families with children experiencing homelessness or at risk of becoming homeless. Partnerships are at the cornerstone of all we do. It is our belief that a good education becomes a great foundation for success. We've been honored to partner with the Homeless Children's Education Fund for many years and to support its important work in helping to uplift these children and youth. Together, we work toward the common goal of getting the children on more stable paths, enabling them to see a brighter future, and preparing to meet the challenges that they will face in life. We are deeply touched by this recognition, but we are most appreciative of the work that Carlos Carter and his entire team does day in and day out. As champions for children, they change lives. Thank you for this honor that keeps us grounded in the work we do.
Thank you so much, Big Sister Pam, as I call her, in Pittsburgh Child Guidance. We appreciate you. Thanks for your kind words, and thanks for all you do for the community. Whoops, sorry. Thank you for all you do for the community. Next, we have Mark Gensheimer as our second champion. You know, Mark is a great guy, great man. He's a long supporter of HCEF and our work. But not only does he support us, he does so much from Swickley, just all around the region, to really help and improve the lives of children and their education. And so we're so excited to present to you, Mark. So Mark, let's hear from you.
Thank you very much, Carlos. You know, there's nothing more important than caring for our children. And in my opinion, all children are our children. You know, I'm sure you've been to a baptism before. At a baptism, the entire congregation pledges to support that child on their journey of faith throughout their life. You know, have you ever seen a child before who you didn't want to just pick up and hug? You know, they're so innocent, they're so sinless, and frankly, even well cared for children need the support and love of other adults in their lives. You know, in the book of Matthew, Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." You know, we're all children of God, and it's our obligation to care for children. You know, frankly, I'm truly humbled to be recognized as someone that cares for kids. But to tell you the truth, the real heroes are those who work for the Homeless Children Education Fund that work tirelessly every day to care for these kids. You know, I think being outnumbered by a wonderful wife of 37 years and four beautiful daughters, you know, it's inspired me to be aware that many kids aren't as fortunate as our children have been. You know, just try to imagine for a brief moment that one of your children, or maybe all of them, are homeless and may not know where they're going to sleep that night, not know where their next meal is going to come from, you know, not know if they're going to be able to go to school tomorrow. You know, so thank you to all of you who care for these children. And to all of you out there tonight, please think about how you can get involved. You know, we all have gifts that we can share, and there isn't a better way to share those gifts than in the support of children. You know, kids that need a break, kids that need to be loved. I mean, just give them a chance. You know, they need our support and they need our love. And, you know, thank you very, very much. This recognition is greatly, greatly appreciated. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Mark. You know, we appreciate you. You know, the award is very, very deserved. So thanks for being a friend and partner of HCEF and our work. Next, I'd like to introduce our board, lovely board chair, Joe Clark, who's going to present the Linda Dickerson Award. And quickly before she does, I was going to say Joe is an awesome board chair. She's a new board chair this year, and we're just so glad to have her. Love her heart, her leadership. And so, Joe, I'll hand it off to you.
Thank you very much, Carlos. It is an honor to present the Linda Dickerson Award tonight. Linda was special to HCEF as one of the founding board members. She helped form who we are today as an organization serving youth and was awarded the Champion for Children Award in 2007. Following her receipt of this award, HCEF decided that her continuous and direct day-to-day support merited an award in her name. Linda passed away in 2020. Her passing is felt deeply in Pittsburgh and beyond. Linda shared her expertise, time, and treasure with so many charities throughout her life. In essence, her life exemplified true service. We are proud to continue to recognize her many contributions through this award in her name. This year, the Linda Dickerson Award goes to Harry Seuss. Harry has been an important part of HCEF for over a decade. He began as a volunteer on committees after learning about the mission from a business colleague who was also on the HCEF board. Harry was astounded to learn of the number of children experiencing homelessness in all local school districts. As Harry became involved in HCEF, he gradually ramped up involvement, eventually joining the Board of Trustees, where he served as treasurer and most recently as board chair before stepping down at the end of 2020. Harry set high expectations for his peers and for all associated with HCEF, and he led by example. In 2019, he ran in the Pittsburgh Marathon 5K event, although he said he was not really a quote unquote runner. He wanted to make sure HCEF achieved the threshold to become an official charity for the marathon in future years, and we did. When asked to reflect on the biggest accomplishment during his tenure as board chair, Harry cited the founder transition to an organization that can stand on its own two feet, financially strong, and able to continue the original vision with new leadership and highly educated professional staff. Harry provided exceptional leadership during this important transition and has set HCEF up for continued long-term success and stability. On a personal level, Harry was a great role model for me as I began my tenure as board chair. Harry shared that serving on the Homeless Children's Education Fund board has made him a better person, and he encouraged people to get involved and serve on small, local, not-for-profit organizations with missions they embrace. Harry, you deserve this award. You've left a positive mark on our organization. You guided us through many transitions and challenged us to become more sophisticated and to grow. You will continue to inspire us. We value your friendship, your leadership, and your willingness to serve our community. And we thank you for your dedication and commitment to HCEF.
Joe, Carlos, and the people who supported my nomination for this prestigious award, thank you very much. To have my name associated and my volunteer efforts associated with the many accomplishments of the late Linda Dickerson is unbelievably rewarding. Linda was often described as a person who knew how to get things done to benefit people who needed a little help to reach their full capabilities. About 10 years ago, when I first learned that Allegheny County had children experiencing homelessness, I was emotionally moved and in disbelief. After attending a few HCEF meetings and speaking with the founder of HCEF and visiting homeless shelters, I made HCEF the major focus of my volunteer efforts. One thing about HCEF that really I connected with strongly was that it's local in all respects. All monies remain in Western Pennsylvania, and that's where our efforts are focused. Today, we have over 4,000 children in Allegheny County experiencing homelessness who need help to fill the gaps in our education system. To me, education undoubtedly is the best ingredient to end homelessness. Please keep in mind that the children who have and are experiencing homelessness did nothing wrong. The other aspect of this mission is that whether rich or poor, the events that lead to child homelessness are many and are present in every district in our community. The HCEF employees are highly motivated, educated, and determined. I like to describe our employees as the boots on the ground that actually get things done in the community, including during the COVID-19 pandemic, when the HCEF employees pivoted fast and found ways to stay in touch both virtually and in person with the families of the children experiencing homelessness. Carlos and the HCEF employees are very dedicated, and this made me more committed to be my very best with my efforts and dedication to HCEF. So tonight, I ask you to please take time, learn and repeat the HCEF success stories that you will hear as part of our program and spread the word. This approach has allowed me to recruit many new volunteers and donors to HCEF. My time with HCEF has been the most rewarding of my volunteer time in my lifetime. And so thank you very much for this prestigious award, and please support this organization. Thank you.
Congratulations again to all of our awardees. Now I told you we're bringing the fun tonight, so we're about to do just that. But first, I want to remind you about the silent auction. If you haven't checked out all of the items, if you have not placed your bids, do get them in, because remember, we are closing it down at 8:30 p.m. sharp. All right, y'all, so it's time to get up out of your seats, because we're bringing Lindsay back. She was amazing. You know, she's already blessed us with a very energizing song, and she's about to do that for us again. So get off your couches, get on up, and let's bring back the fabulous Lindsay Smith. And did I mention to you that she is joining us all the way from New Orleans? Lindsay, take it away.
During this event, I want to make sure, and I would be remiss if I did not mention, that this event is so important, and the Homeless Children's Education Fund is so important to Pittsburgh children by far and wide. I've shared my testimony in past events that I performed about my soon-to-be adopted son. His name is Savon, who was my student and ended up being a part of my family because he was. Can you guys hear me? Hello there. Can you hear? Okay, hold on. I'm gonna adjust my microphone. It was working. So I want to make sure that I would be remiss. Can you guys hear me now? You hear me? Great. I apologize for the technical difficulties. It's very low. I'm hearing. Okay, hold on 1 second. I'm gonna. Beautiful Zoom world. Give me 1 second. It's awesome now. Okay, good. So I would be remiss not to mention that my son was homeless at one point. He was my student, and unfortunately, there were no benefits available that I knew of to take care of this child. He is now in college, just due to people caring enough. And I promise you that every single one of you outreaching to homeless children, it makes a huge difference. He's finishing his freshman year, getting ready to go on his first trip out of the country with our family to Dominican Republic. So I say that to say, keep up the work. Everything that you do, every child that you reach, it will make a difference. And I'm so grateful from the outside looking in for each and every one of you guys. So we're going to go ahead and do a couple of inspirational but fun songs, and then I'll turn it back over to Wadria. But thank you so much for having me. All right, y'all. I need to get everybody to put their snaps up. Hey. Three little birds sat on my window, and they told me I don't need to worry. Summer came like cinnamon, so sweet. Little girls double dutch on the concrete. Maybe sometimes things turn out wrong, but it's all right. The more things seem to change, The more they seem the same. Don't you think it's strange, girl? Put your records on, sing your favorite song. Just go ahead and let your hair down. Sapphire and faded jeans. I hope you get your dreams. You go ahead and your hair down. You're gonna find yourself some way, somehow. Blue has a sky, sunburned and lonely, sipping tea in a bar by the roadside. Don't you let those other boys fool you. Gotta love that Afro hairdo. Maybe sometimes you may be scared, but it's all right. The more things stay the same, oh, the more they seem to change. So don't you hesitate, girl, put your records on, tell me your favorite song. You go ahead, let your hair down. Sapphire and faded jeans, I hope you get your dream. Just go ahead, let your hair down. You're gonna find yourself somewhere, somehow. Just more than I could take. Pity for pity's sake. I thought that I was a way. Maybe I was just stronger. And you're gonna realize that you don't even have to try any longer. Do what you want to. Girl, put your records on, baby. Just go ahead and let your hair down. Sapphire and faded jeans. I hope you get your dreams. Just go ahead, let your hair down. Won't you let your hair down, baby? Oh, 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 oh. Just go ahead, let your hair down. And oh, sapphire and faded jeans. I hope you get your dream. You go ahead, let your hair down. You're gonna find yourself someday, somehow. Ooh. I have one more for you guys, and I think this is going to inspire each and every one of you. I'm not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say. We don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. I'm not afraid to go in the dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are marvelous. Though the sharpest word wanna cut me down, gonna send a breath, gonna drown the mouth. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me. Oh, 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 oh. Another round of bullets hits my skin. Well, fire away, cause today I won't let the shame sink in. We are bursting through the barricades and reaching towards the sun. Oh yeah, that's what we become. I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. Though the sharpest words wanna cut me down, I'm gonna send a flood, gonna drown them out. I am Bruce. I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me. Oh. And I know that I deserve your love. Gonna cut me down. Gonna say the fuck, gonna drown him out. This is brave, this is rude, this is who I'm meant to be, this is me. Look out, this here I go, yeah, yeah. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I make no apologies. This is me. No one is gonna bring me down. I am brave, I am Bruce, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Have a great night. Once again, take it away, Wadria.
Woo! Lindsay,
you are incredible. That was amazing. The message behind both of those songs. And I must say, thank God for the mute button, because I was over here finding myself wanting to sing along, but thank God for the mute button. you are amazing. Y'all show Lindsay some love. Show her some love. That was incredible. I have chills. Thank you so, so very much, Lindsay. And guys, at this time, as we transition to the next segment of our program, I'd like to introduce you to another incredible young woman, Veronica Hickman. She's going to be sharing her personal story, and we will also hear Michael's story. Now, both of these young adults have, they've won our Hope Through Learning Award, and they've each used the award money for expenses associated with their, with college. Now, they've both experienced homelessness, and they each demonstrate a level of courage, of resilience, and hope on so many levels. Take a look.
Isn't it such a great night so far? Hello, everyone. Hi. Remember me, Veronica Hickman? I was featured last year at this event. Thank you for having me. I also would like to thank the entire Homeless Children's Education Fund for all they've done for me throughout the years. We'll come back to that part in a little bit. But first, I really wanted to share a story that really touched my heart, and I'm sure will touch yours as well. This story is from a recent award recipient, a young man who endured so much yet remains focused on overcoming every challenge that has been thrown his way. When a student applies for the Hope Through Learning Award, they are asked to write a personal essay. Let me share some of his essay with you now. It paints quite a picture.
In the spring of 2019, as I was getting close to the end of my junior year of high school, I was baffled by something I never saw coming. One day, I came home from work, walked in the door, and my grandparents and everything that came with them had left the house. The place was empty. No furniture, no TV, no nothing. Scraps of food were left here and there, but I had no idea what happened. I tried calling them every day, but they never answered or responded. Supplies became more and more limited. As a very active kid who is playing all these sports, working hard in the classroom, and trying to be the best person I could possibly be, I was sadly giving up and slowing down. I would go to work practically starving, trying to get enough hours so I would have enough money for food and water. I don't remember how much time had passed between when my grandparents left and when I first saw the notice on the front door. The house was in foreclosure. It all started to make sense. My grandparents were my legal guardians because my mother had passed away when I was very young, and my father went to prison shortly thereafter and gave my grandparents custody of me. I had nowhere to go besides that house. My guess was that money was tight for them because I heard them say the mortgage wasn't being paid. Eventually, the utilities were shut off, leaving me to use a gallon jug of water to help flush the toilet, charging my phone at school, and sleeping with no heat at night, and then no air conditioning in the summer. My experience with homelessness really changed me as a person and my mindset about life in general. At first, there was a lot of pain, anger, and depression. I woke up and made sure not to take it out on other people or gain sympathy from other people just because of my situation. I wanted no special treatment. I wanted to be looked at just the way everyone else was. My situation made me reevaluate myself and my priorities and to not worry about little things and to keep myself away from the streets. The little things that I thought mattered really didn't. It also changed the way I viewed people. Prior to being homeless, I was kind of a cocky and arrogant kid who only cared about himself and not how other people felt. Now, I try to reach out to other people, even if no one else does, just to see if they're okay.
This story is meaningful to me since the Hope Through Learning Award is how I first got connected with HCEF when I was a teenager. This program hits home to me. When I was in school, I went through so much. Like, I was the bad kid. I was a kid that was in special education classes. I was a kid that struggled so much. And I was a kid that a lot of teachers counted out, you know, like, you know, you're from the city, like, you're not going to make nothing out of yourself. So it's like, it's just like a thing where, like, you wanted to prove people wrong. And I had those teachers who helped me and pushed me along. And then I had those teachers who just treated me like I wasn't nothing and, you know, looked at me like I wouldn't be anything. But then I had a principal, my favorite principal, Miss Walker, who she always took me under her wing. And she was just like, you're going to get yourself together. Like, you're not going to keep getting pulled out of class. You're not going to keep, you know, being like this in school, things like that. And she basically just pulled me under her wing. And I just learned from her. Like, she was the best principal ever. Like, she always, you know, checked on me, and she was just always supportive and always just like acknowledged what I was going through and my feelings. If I didn't win the Hope Through Learning Award, I wouldn't have won the college because, like, for instance, like, when you go to college, you have to have the necessities, like your bedding, your food, extra money. Like, I didn't have, like, again, like, my parents, they did the best they could, but it's like, I'm not gonna take all their money for me to go to college. So again, like, I was depending on the scholarship. I depended on it so much to a point where, like, I just said, like, if I don't win, I'm not going to college right away. So I probably would have ended up on a different path. I'm just still overjoyed. Like, I still remember when I first won. And I still just remember how my face was. Like, it's just interesting to, like, just, I don't know. It's just a good and crazy feeling because, again, like, I kind of looked at it like, wow, like, there are people who care about you, you know? Like, because sometimes you feel like there's people that's just not there, people who just overlook you and your family, or just people who just don't care. So it's like, wow, like, HCEF, they do care, and they do everything possible to show that they care. And they even stayed connected with me throughout my whole journey in college. Like, I won the scholarship in 2014, I'm still connected to them till this day. But the whole time in college, like, they helped me each year when I went back to college, like, you know, backpacks, supplies, things like that. We went bowling, we did bowling nights, we did lots of other things. So we stayed connected throughout the whole time I finished college. And you see, like, I'm still connected to them now. I work for them now. So it's like, come on, like, HCEF is just like, I love them so much. I'm grateful for HCEF. With their help, I was able to obtain not only my bachelor's degree from Edinburgh University, but my master's degree from Carleton University. Now, you all heard my story. Don't be afraid to tell yours. As Maya Angelou once said, do the best you can until you know better. Then when you know better, do better. Thank you.
Wow. I know those stories, hearing them, so powerful. And let's just take a moment to let those stories sink in. I mean, I cannot even begin to imagine coming home as a student in high school and coming home and not finding my loved ones there, not finding anything. So difficult to imagine that. So as we did in 2019, we are launching a special appeal tonight. You may find it on your phones, and you actually can just click on the donate button that is on the auction site. So with that, you know, we're so honored to have our event chairs and HCEF longtime supporters and special friends, Paul and Nancy Collier, to talk with you about the impact of your support tonight. One moment.
As you know, this has been a devastating year around the world with the COVID pandemic. Many people, us included, have actually done well through the pandemic. We've kept our jobs, we've kept our income, kept our businesses going, stock market's up, our pensions are doing very well. But if you reflect on it, the other half of the country has done poorly. Unemployment's up. People in the service industries have died at a disproportionate rate. Incomes are down. Jobs are lost. Homelessness is up. And homelessness among children has gone sky high. This year, we're asking you to think of all the people, the tremendous need that's been generated, the families, the children that are homeless, that you can help. And we dug deep and we've tried to help, and I'll turn this over to Nancy to tell you how you can support.
And there are a ton of ways you can help, and everything is appreciated, and these kids appreciate it. An example would be $2,500 could support a scholarship for a student entering a college or trade school. Paul and I decided that's what we were going to do. We did a sponsor of two children. $1,000 would support one child for a full year in an after-school program. $500 could support a one-on-one coaching for our teen outreach program. And $250 could support a cultural or a STEAM enrichment program like clay or puppet making with Mr. Dave. It's so important. I mean, our future are these kids. And if you could just dig deep, anything you could give would be tremendously appreciated. And I always think of my mother, who taught us, if you give what you have, it'll come back twofold. And it may not come back in the form of money, but it'll come back in the form of good people that you helped. So please, please, please help us.
We're hoping while these appeals are still in your heart, that you decide to give right now. You should already be in the Greater Giving app. It's where the auction was held. Just navigate to the donate section and give what you can now. It will be greatly appreciated. Use the great help and hopefully help a lot of these kids that are struggling.
And we love you all, and we're so glad you're even here with us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nancy and Paul. Now, please think about the stories that you've heard. You can be that link between uncertainty and stability, between unstable housing and a promising future. You are a bridge to hope, and none of the work that we do at HCEF could be possible without your contributions and without your time and without your efforts and without you being here with us tonight. All right, everyone, thank you so much for joining us here tonight. I know that I had a wonderful time, and I can see from the responses, I could see from your messages in the chat section, I could see that you all have enjoyed your time with us as well. I saw that some of you were joining as far as Florida. I saw someone is joining us from South Carolina. So it's incredible that even though we're doing this virtually, that we're all able to come together from all over the country, like literally. So again, thank you for giving us your time tonight. Hopefully you had a great time. And I see my fantastic cohort here, Carlos, just rejoined us. Carlos, can you share some remarks? Like what has tonight been like for you?
Well, you know, it just makes me, you know, proud as a leader to serve an organization that, like I said, that serves with love, because it's not important to me just what we do, it's how we do it. And, you know, and our people do everything with love. And so I think that's a reflection of my leadership, our board, and who we are. Because at the end of the day, education is very important, but people are most important. And so if they don't feel valued, loved, and supported, you know, nothing matters. And so I'm just inspired by our team members, you know, hearing how they're serving, inspired by the stories of Veronica. She's amazing. And Michael, you know, our awardees, Pam, Mark, and Harry, just everybody. I'm just really touched and inspired. And that Lindsay, how could you forget her? I mean, her singing was amazing. I was dancing. You guys could see me too. Just move. I could just feel every note. You know, it just shook me to my core in a positive way. And, you know, and you know, someone once said that children are not a distraction to more important work. They are the most important work. You know, thanks to our donors, sponsors, board, and team, all of you tonight for your support and commitment to helping our kids win in school and life. You know, because without education, it's difficult to break the cycle of homelessness. And we are grateful that you're committed to helping our kids win and break the cycle of homelessness through education and supports. Because of you, we can create hope through learning. And so at the end of the day, as I said in our various videos, we just want to see our kids win. That's this one, our kids that win. You know, despite their challenges, they're amazing. You know, our job is not to be the light, but our job is to help remove the shade, a barrier, so their lights can shine. They're all the light, and our job is to help to illuminate that. And also, Wadeer, you are coming, right? That's why I chose you. Like, awesome, and you're just amazing. You know, Jamaica's finest by way of Brooklyn, by way of Jamaica. And so just thank you for your spirit and your light tonight. I enjoyed just having you here. So thank you so much, and for your friendship.
Thank you so much, Carlos. And next time we do this, you guys, I know we will be in the same space. So cannot wait to see you in person. Cannot wait to give you all some hugs. But let me remind you guys, we still have a silent auction going on. All right. You have a little bit, what is it? It's 8:13. So you have some minutes left to go on and place your bids. Guys, listen, I know we've all been kind of in a quarantine and in on lockdown. So we have two getaways. All right. There's a week-long stay to Florida that is still open. I don't know if we have any bids on that yet. So listen, if you're like me, you're kind of strategic, you're waiting, go in there right now and place your bids, because we are shutting it down at 8:30. All right. So please go on in there, check out the amazing items, place your bids. And as a final reminder, you will receive an email with instructions as to how to claim your winnings. So this was amazing. Thank you so much for spending your Thursday evening with us. Certainly your time, your efforts, your contributions are not in vain. So Carlos, any final words before we end?
Yes. Thank our event chairs, Nancy. They're so amazing. I just love their hearts. They're sincere. And I love Nancy because she'll cry quickly. So will Paul too, if you get them. But you know, they really care. And you know, they're people who have been very successful, but they've never forgotten, you know, where they come from. But they're about people first. They're about love first. And I consider them friends because they're real. I love real people, and they certainly are that. But thank you guys so much. And again, the team, the board, all the guys for attending, just everybody. I'm just so grateful to everyone for making night simply amazing.
Awesome. So with that, you guys have a wonderful evening, and we'll be seeing you again very soon. Thank you so much.
Good night. Bye.